क्लास 8 एनसीईआरटी सोशल साइंस चैप्टर 5 इंडस्ट्रीज। हैव यू एवर गिवन अ थॉट टू द फैक्ट दैट द नोटबुक यू यूज फॉर राइटिंग हैज कम टू यू आफ्टर अ लॉन्ग प्रोसेस ऑफ मैन्युफैक्चरिंग। इट स्टार्टेड इट्स लाइफ एज पार्ट ऑफ अ ट्री। इट वॉज कट डाउन एंड ट्रांसपोर्टेड टू द pulp mill. There the wood of the tree was processed and converted into wood pulp. The wood pulp was mixed with chemicals and finally changed into paper by machines. This paper found its way to the press, where ink made from chemicals was used to print the lines on the pages. The pages were then bound in the form of a notebook, packed and sent to the market for sale. Finally, it reached your hands. Secondary activities or manufacturing change raw materials into products of more value to people. As you have seen, pulp was changed into paper and paper into a notebook. These represent the two stages of the manufacturing process. The paper made from pulp and cloth made from cotton have had value added to them at each stage of the manufacturing process. In this way, the finished product has more value and utility than the raw material that it is made from. Industry refers to an economic activity that is concerned with production of goods, extraction of minerals, or the provision of services. Thus, we have iron and steel industry. What it does for the production of goods? Coal mining industry, which extract the coal, extraction of coal, and tourism industry, it provides service. So this is a service industry. Classification of industries. Industries can be classified on the basis of raw materials, size, and ownership. Raw materials. Industries may be agro-based, mineral-based, marine-based, and forest-based. Depending on the types of raw materials they use. Agro-based industries use plant and animal-based products as their raw materials. Food processing, vegetable oil, cotton textile, dairy products and leather industries are examples of agro-based industries. Mineral-based industries are primary industries that use mineral ores as their raw materials. The products of these industries feed other industries. Iron made from iron ore is the product of mineral-based industry. This is used as raw material for the manufacture of a number of other products such as heavy machinery, building materials, and railway coaches. Marine-based industries use products from the sea and ocean as raw materials. Industries processing seafood or manufacturing fish oil are some examples. Forest-based industries utilize forest produce as raw materials. The industries associated with forest are pulp and paper, pharmaceuticals, furniture, and buildings. Size. On the basis of size, industries are divided into small scale, large scale. It refers to the amount of capital invested. Number of people employed, and volume of production. Based on size, industries can be classified into small scale and large scale industries. Cottage or household industries are a type of small-scale industry where the products are manufactured by hand by the artisans. Basket weaving, pottery, and other handicrafts are examples of cottage industry. Small scale industries use lesser amount of capital and technology as compared to large scale industries that produce large volumes of products. Investment of capital is higher and the technology used is superior in large scale industries. Silk weaving food processing industries are small scale industries. Production of automobiles and heavy machinery are large scale industries. Ownership. On the basis of ownership, also industries are divided into following. Industries can be classified into private sector and state owned or public sector, and joint sector and cooperative sector. Private sector industries are owned and operated by individuals or a group of individuals. The public sector industries are owned and operated by the government, such as Hindustan Aeronautics Limited and Steel Authority of India Limited. Joint sector industries are owned and operated by the state and individuals or a group of individuals. Maruti Udyog Limited is an example of joint sector industry. Cooperative sector industries are owned and operated by the producers and suppliers of raw materials, workers or both. Anand Milk Union Limited and Sudha Dairy are a success story of a cooperative venture. Factors affecting location of industries. These are the following factors which affect the location of industries. These are raw material, availability of labor, capital, market, availability of power, land, transport. Factors affecting location of industries. The factors affecting the location of industries are the availability of raw material, land, water, labor, power, capital, transport, and market. Industries are situated where some or all of these factors are easily available. Sometimes the government provides incentives like subsidized power, lower transport cost, and other infrastructure so that industries may be located in backward areas. Industrialization often leads to development and growth of towns and cities. Industrial system. An industrial system consists of inputs, processes, and outputs. Inputs are the raw material, labor, cost of land, transport, power, and other infrastructure. The processes include a wide range of activities that convert the raw material into finished products. The outputs are the end product and the income earned from it. In case of the textile industry, the inputs may be cotton, human labor, factory, and transport cost. The processes include ginning, spinning, weaving, dyeing, and printing. The output is the shirt you wear. Industrial regions. Industrial regions emerge when a number of industries locate close to each other and share the benefits of their closeness. Major industrial regions of the world are Eastern North America, Western and Central Europe, Eastern Europe, and Eastern Asia. Major industrial regions tend to be located in the temperate areas near seaport, especially near coalfield. Near seaport, in temperate areas, and near coalfield. India has several industrial regions like Mumbai Pune cluster, Bangalore Tamil Nadu region, Hooghly region, Ahmedabad Baroda region, Chotanagpur industrial belt, Visakhapatnam Guntur belt, Gurgaon Delhi Meerut region, Kollam Thiruvananthapuram industrial cluster. industrial disaster. In industries, accidents, disasters mainly occur due to technical failure or irresponsible handling of hazardous material. One of the worst industrial disasters of all time occurred in Bhopal on 3 December 1984 around 12:30 o'clock. It was a technical accident in which highly poisonous methyl isocyanate gas along with hydrogen cyanide and other reaction products leaked out of the pesticide factory of Union Carbide. The official death toll was 3,598. In 1989, thousands who survived still suffer from one or many ailments like blindness, impaired immune system, gastrointestinal disorders, etc. In another incident, on 23rd December 2005, due to gas will blow out in Gaoqiao, Chongqing, China, 243 people died, 9,000 were injured, 64,000 were evacuated. Many people died because they were unable to run after the explosion. Those who could not escape in time suffered burns to their eyes, skin and lungs from the gas. Risk reduction measures. Densely populated residential areas should be separated far away from the industrial areas. People staying in the vicinity of industries should be aware of storage of toxins. Should be aware of storage of toxins or hazardous substances and their possible effects in case if an accident occurs. Fire warning and fighting system should be improved. Storage capacity of toxic substances should be limited. Pollution dispersion qualities in the industries should be improved. Emerging industries are also known as sunrise industry. These include information technology, wellness, hospitality, and knowledge. Distribution of major industries. The world's major industries are the iron and steel industry, the textile industry, and the information technology industry. The iron and steel and textile industry are the older industries, while information technology is an emerging industry. The countries in which iron and steel industry is located are Germany, USA, China, Japan, and Russia. Textile industry is concentrated in India, Hong Kong, South Korea, Japan, and Taiwan. The major hubs of information technology industries are the Silicon Valley of Central California and Bangalore region of India. Iron and steel industry. Like other industries, iron and steel industry too comprises various inputs, processes, and outputs. This is a feeder industry whose products are used as raw material for other industries. The inputs for the industry include raw materials such as iron ore, coal, limestone, along with labor, capital, site, and other infrastructure. The process of converting iron ore into steel involves many stages. The raw material is put in the blast furnace where it undergoes a smelting. It is then refined. The output obtained is steel, which may be used by other industries as raw material. Smelting. It is the process in which metals are extracted from their ores by heating beyond the melting point. Here, 8 tons of coal and 4 tons of iron ore and 1 ton of limestone is required to produce 1 ton of steel. Steel is tough and it can be easily shaped, cut or made into wire. Special alloys of steel can be made by adding a small amount of other metals such as aluminium, nickel and copper. Alloys give steel unusual hardness, toughness or ability to resist rust. Alloys are those substances which are prepared by in which one metal is mixed with another metal or with another non-metal to make a more bitter substance with more good qualities. Steel is often called the backbone of modern industry. Almost everything we use is either made of iron or steel or has been made with tools and machinery of these metals. Ships, trains, trucks and autos are made largely of steel. Even the safety pins and the needles you use are made from steel. Oil wells are drilled with steel machinery. Steel pipelines transport oil. Minerals are mined with steel equipment. Farm machines are mostly steel. Large buildings have steel framework. Before 1880, iron and steel industry was located where raw materials, power supply and running water were easily available. Later, the ideal location for the industry was near coal fields and close to canals and railways. After 1950, iron and steel industry began to be located on large areas of flatland near seaports. This is because by this time the steel works had become very large and iron ore had to be imported from overseas. In India, iron and steel industry has developed taking advantage of raw materials, cheap labor, transport and market. All the important steel producing centers such as Bhilai, Durgapur, Burnpur, Jamshedpur, Rourkela, Bokaro are situated in the region that spreads over 4 states: West Bengal, Jharkhand, Odisha, Chhattisgarh, Bhadravati and Vijayanagar in Karnataka, Vishakhapatnam in Andhra Pradesh, Salem in Tamil Nadu are other important steel centers utilizing local resources. Jamshedpur. Before 1947, there was only one iron and steel plant in the country, Tata Iron and Steel Company Limited, that is TISCO. It was privately owned. After independence, the government took the initiative and set up several iron and steel plants. TISCO was started in 1907 at Sakchi, near the confluence of the rivers Subarnarekha and Kharkhai in Jharkhand. Later on, Sakchi was renamed as Jamshedpur. Geographically, Jamshedpur is the most conveniently situated iron and steel center in the country. Sakchi was chosen to set up the steel plant for several reasons. This place was only 32 km from Kalimati station on the Bengal-Nagpur railway line. It was close to the iron ore, coal, manganese deposits as well as to Kolkata, which provided a large market. TISCO gets coal from Jharia coalfield and iron ore limestone dolomite and manganese from Odisha and Chhattisgarh. The Kharkhai and Subarnarekha rivers ensured sufficient water supply. Government initiatives provided adequate capital for its later development. In Jamshedpur, several other industrial plants were set up after TISCO. They produce chemicals, locomotive parts, agricultural equipment, machinery, tin plate, cable and wire. The development of the iron and steel industry opened the doors to rapid industrial development in India. Almost all sectors of the Indian industry depend heavily on the iron and steel industry for their basic infrastructure. The Indian iron and steel industry consists of large integrated steel plants as well as mini steel plants. It also includes secondary producers, rolling mills and ancillary industries. Pittsburgh. It is an important steel city of the United States of America. The steel industry at Pittsburgh enjoys locational advantages. Some of the raw materials such as coal is available locally, while the iron ore comes from the iron mines at Minnesota, about 1500 km from Pittsburgh. Between these mines and Pittsburgh is one of the world's best routes for shipping ore cheaply, the famous Great Lakes Waterway. Trains carry the ore from the Great Lakes to the Pittsburgh area. The Ohio, the Monongahela and Allegheny rivers provide adequate water supply. Today, very few of the large steel mills are in Pittsburgh itself. They are located in the valleys of the Monongahela and Allegheny rivers above Pittsburgh and along the Ohio River below it. Finished steel is transported to the market by both land and water routes. The Pittsburgh area has many factories other than steel mills. These use steel as their raw material to make many different products such as railroad equipment, heavy machinery and rails. Cotton textile industry, weaving cloth from the yarn, is an ancient art. Cotton wool, silk, jute, flax has been used for making cloth. The textile industry can be divided on the basis of raw materials used in them. Fibers are the raw material of textile industry. Fibers can be natural or man-made. Natural fibers are obtained from wool, silk, cotton, linen, and jute. Man-made fibers include nylon, polyester, acrylic, and rayon. The cotton textile industry is one of the oldest industries in the world. Till the Industrial Revolution in the 18th century, cotton cloth was made using hand-spinning techniques, wheels and looms. In the 18th century, powerful looms facilitated the development of cotton textile industry, first in Britain and later in other parts of the world. Today, India, China, Japan and the USA are important producers of cotton textiles. India has a glorious tradition of producing excellent quality cotton textiles before the British rule. Indian hand-spun and hand-woven cloth already had a wide market. The muslins of Dhaka, chintzes of Masulipatnam, calicos of Calicut and gold wrought cotton of Burhanpur, Surat and Vadodara were known worldwide for their quality and design. But the production of hand-woven cotton textile was expensive and time-consuming. Hence, the traditional cotton textile industry could not face the competition from the niche textile mills of the West, which produced cheap and good quality fabrics through mechanized industrial units. The first successful mechanized textile mill was established in Mumbai in 1854. The warm, moist climate, a port for importing machinery, Availability of raw material and skilled labor resulted in rapid expansion of the industry in the region. Initially, this industry flourished in the states of Maharashtra and Gujarat because of favorable humid climate, but today, humidity can be created artificially and raw cotton is a pure and not weight-losing raw material. So this industry has spread to other parts of India. Coimbatore, Kanpur, Chennai, Ahmedabad, Mumbai, Kolkata, Ludhiana, Puducherry and Panipat are some of the other important centers. Ahmedabad. It is located in Gujarat on the banks of the Sabarmati River. The first mill was established in 1859. It soon became the second largest textile city of India after Mumbai. Ahmedabad was therefore often referred to as the Manchester of India. Favorable locational factors were responsible for the development of the textile industry in Ahmedabad. Ahmedabad is situated very close to cotton growing area. This ensures easy availability of raw material. The climate is ideal for spinning and weaving. The flat terrain and easy availability of land is suitable for the establishment of the mills. The densely populated states of Gujarat and Maharashtra provide both skilled and semi-skilled labor. Well-developed road and railway network permits easy transportation of textiles to different parts of the country, thus providing easy access to the market. Mumbai port nearby facilitates import of machinery and export of cotton textiles. But in the recent years, Ahmedabad textile mills have been having some problems. Several textile mills have closed down. This is primarily due to the emergence of new textile centers in the country as well as non-upgradation of machines and technology in the mills of Ahmedabad. Osaka. It is an important textile center of Japan, also known as the Manchester of Japan. The textile industry developed in Osaka due to several geographical factors. The expansive plain around Osaka ensured that land was easily available for the growth of cotton mills. Warm, humid climate is well suited to spinning and weaving. The river Yodo provides sufficient water for the mills. Labor is easily available. Location of port facilities, import of raw cotton and for exporting textiles. The textile industry at Osaka depends completely upon imported raw materials. Cotton is imported from Egypt, India, China and USA. The finished product is mostly exported and has a good market due to good quality and low price, though it is one of the important textile cities in the country of late. The cotton textile industry of Osaka has been replaced by other industries such as iron and steel, machinery, shipbuilding, automobiles, electrical equipment and cement. Take the correct answer. Fort Gloucester is located in West Bengal. Which one of the following is a natural fiber? Jute. Do you know the first textile mill in the country was established at Fort Gloucester near Kolkata in 1818, but it closed down after some time.